So this is a wine by Dariush, which is an excellent boutique winemaker in Napa. And this is their Caravan bottling from 2013. It's dominantly Cabernet, blended with some Merlot, Cab Franc, and Petit Verdot. And it is just an excellent example of why Napa Valley wines are some of the best wines in the world. So for me, Cabin Steak is as classic as it gets. And we're going to do that today for sure. One thing I love about Cabot is it also has a very savory component to it. It has this, for me with Napa, I get a little bit of this, you know, menthol, green cooling characteristic from the wines.
Yeah.
And it's a hallmark sign of Cabernet Sauvignon.
Right.
As well as this beautiful tobacco, leather kind of characteristic, even a smokiness, especially on this wine. I really, really enjoy. So, you know, for me with this wine, you know, smoked meat.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that's
smoked meat,
that
man.
Is
I'm, pretty, I'm, yeah. I live on a big island.
Yep, there you go.
Smoked meat and OP.
Yep, there you go. You got it all. I got the wines for you, Chef.
So, Chef, now we're down to our final dish.
We got a nice, beautiful Hawaii Ranchers beef ribeye.
Yeah.
So we're going to use some local product again. And you know the importance of seasoning our food. So we're going to give it a nice salt. And then this is a peppercorn blend. So we use a little pink peppercorn, Szechuan peppercorn, and black pepper. So we're going to season that pretty heavily.
Okay.
And then we have our pan starting to get hot. Put just a touch of oil in there.
Okay.
And we want to wait until that oil shimmers a little bit. So we'll get our veg going right here.
Okay.
And then we're going to add our steak in. You always want to hear that sizzle when you add the meat in the pan. Season the other side. And then get that going. Meanwhile, over here we have
kabocha, or
it's a kabocha. You got it right on the nose. So it's a kabocha squash, and then we pureed that with a little bit of carrot.
Very nice.
And then also some warm spices, so nutmeg, cinnamon, clove. Just give it a little bit of extra, a little bit of extra character and flavor. So our beef is searing away. We want to make sure that nice and brown. So at this point, I'm going to flip it over.
Beautiful.
And then we're going to finish it cooking in the oven. So now that our puree is heating up, we can start to saute our vegetables. So we'll get our pan really hot. We have some Brussels sprout leaves.
That's nice.
We're gonna add those in, get a little char on them.
Caramelize, get the flavor out.
Caramelize them. So. Give these a quick toss. See, they're starting to char already.
Uh-huh. No seasoning, right?
I put the seasoning in after so that the salt doesn't draw out the moisture.
Right.
So we start to get that color right away. So you can see we're starting to pick up a nice char.
Very nice.
And then now I'm going to start to add a little bit of our salt.
Beautiful.
Toss. Add a little bit of our pepper.
The pepper blend.
And then here we have a nice reduction. So this is a red wine reduction. Finished with a little bit of veal demi.
Okay.
So we're hoping there that the flavors are going to complement what Micah has in store for us. So to finish off these Brussels sprouts, I'm going to add some more diced kabocha squash. So this has been diced and then far roasted. Only gives it a little bit of color, as well as it gives it a nice sweetness. So I think that should work well with the wine.
You like this, huh?
I do like this. It's not a bad living.
Yeah.
So I think this is nice and hot, ready to go.
Good.
Our sauces are all ready. So let's check on our steak, and then should be ready to plate up shortly. So here we have our beef. Right now it's a little bit rare still. What we're gonna do is we're gonna finish it by butter basting it. Here I have a little bit of whole butter, and then we're going to melt this in the pan. So we're going to wait till the butter gets brown, And what this does too is it caramelizes the outside of the steak, and it adds a little bit of flavor. And I think the nice thing too is here you can add other flavors too if you want. So here we have a little bit of thyme. And then we're just gonna
beautiful
glaze the steak and the thyme.
The thyme and nice flavor.
And all that is flavoring our beef. And it's still cooking too, because we pulled it while it was just a little bit rare. So I'm hoping that this is gonna echo in the wine and so create a bridge of the flavors. You know, we have the Cabernet that has some of those like menthol herbal flavors that the thyme has as well. So,
but man, I can feel the flavor going through that steak right now.
Awesome. I'm gonna take the steak out of the pan. We're gonna let that rest. And then we can start.
You guys seen that? Hands of steel.
Don't try this at home.
So here we have our kombucha pumpkin puree. Mm-hmm. So this has those nice warm fall spices that we talked mm-hmm. about. So we're just going to do a little round on the plate. And then our steak is resting. Meanwhile, we want to leave
right.
it alone.
Right.
Steak is doing good there, so mm-hmm. we want to leave it doing good. So usually I like to
on the tongs or
to let our beef rest. I'll let it rest for, you know, about a steak this size, quick rest, maybe 4 minutes max.
Yeah.
But if you have a larger steak, a prime rib or something like that.
A big rib eye or
yeah,
something.
You might need to let it rest for up to a half an hour sometimes, depending on what size beef you have. So here we have all those Brussels sprout leaves that we charred.
Nice.
And then we have a little bit of that diced pumpkin in there too.
Oh man, that looks perfect.
So we're gonna cut them up. And then now we've made this nice bed. So we're gonna set our steak nestled in our bed, our Brussels sprout leaves, our kombucha squash puree, and our diced butternut squash, or kombucha squash. And then I also roasted off these mushrooms. And
beautiful.
So we're just gonna add these mushrooms, a little bit of mushroom flavor in the wine. And then finally we have our sauce. So sauce, we have a red wine demi-reduction. And so we'll glaze the beef a little bit with that.
Beautiful.
And also to add just a little crunch, we have some pickled mustard seeds.
Pickled mustard seeds.
So this will add a little bit of acid, some crunch, and some spice.
And there we have it.
That's it.
That is beautiful, Chef.
Thank you.
So what we got here is the Caravan Napa Valley Cab from Dariush. Steak and cab, like I was saying, is one of the most iconic pairings that we have. And, you know, in this case, I couldn't agree more. That actually, the butter basting with the thyme is going to give a nice green characteristic to the steak, which is going to lend extremely well to the wine. And the tannin in the wine is going to really stand up nicely to the fattiness and, you know, the meatiness that this steak has. So
I'm going to get right into this.
Get into it, Chef.
The salt's perfect. The finish with the butter, the thyme, amazing.
So cooking is all about building flavors, and so each one of those steps help build a little bit more flavor, and then hopefully the end result is a well-rounded dish.